Today we will talk about hexagonal architecture. Let's begin. I have a habit of making a shopping list while I am still at home. It is a good habit because it allows you to think about what you need to buy without being distracted by the noise of the grocery store. When I go to the store, however, the list I have is alphabetical. It becomes a problem because the products are arranged according to their categories: fruits, vegetables, bread, dairy, and so on. It will be ineffective if I look through my alphabetically arranged list. That is why categorizing can be useful, because it indicates whether a product is missing or if you need to buy more sweets. In software design, everything must be in its proper place, just like in grocery stores, which is why we require hexagonal architecture. So, what is it exactly? Alistair Cockburn invented and published the hexagonal architecture in 2005 in an attempt to avoid known structural pitfalls in object-oriented software design, such as undesired dependencies between layers and contamination of user interface code with business logic. Hexagonal architecture. A programming architectural pattern in which code in one module communicates with code in other modules only through well-defined interfaces. Rules. Each component is connected to the others through a number of exposed ports. Communication through these ports follows a given protocol depending on their purpose. Ports and protocols define an abstract API that can be implemented by any suitable technical means. Examples given: method invocation in an object-oriented language, remote procedure calls, or web services. The granularity of the ports and their number is not constrained. A single port could in some case be sufficient. Example given: in the case of a simple service consumer, typically, there are ports for event sources, user interface, automatic feeding, notifications, outgoing notifications, database. In order to interface the component with any suitable DBMS, and administration, for controlling the component, in an extreme case, there could be a different port for every use case, if needed. Hexagonal architecture, like everything else, has advantages and disadvantages that should be considered. Advantages of hexagonal architecture. There are clear advantages of using hexagonal architecture. Clear position of the code, readable business layer, one point of connection to service like database or external API. Disadvantages of hexagonal architecture. Hexagonal architecture has also disadvantages. Needs longer time to code, less clear process and actions. In conclusion, the beauty of hexagon architecture is that it is both aesthetically pleasing and logical. Hexagons are ideal for efficiency, which was the design's goal. Hexagonal architecture is an underutilized structure that can be used to improve efficiency in daily life. Because both beauty and efficiency are important in any project, this design makes them both possible. Hexes keep structural searches at bay, making them easily accessible. Where might you find it useful to organize such layers in your personal life? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.